all I can say is you're in for a treat.
Okay. Enjoy. Thank you, John. Let's get a few things straight here. It's me plus all these people versus you.
Can we also get it straight that between you and I, only one of us was aware it was for charity?
There'll be no charity given, that's for sure.
No!
So, are you going to sit there?
No, fine. Okay, is this...
You're in a dungeon.
Oh, hang on, let me... Okay.
The way this is going to work, I don't know if everyone saw it. About 18 months ago, we did this at UK Games Expo. It was really successful. Was anyone there?
Yeah!
Okay. So, you know how it's going to work. We're going to not go out and hear very much the rules, but there will be some dice rolling, a lot of cheating. Your job is to make him make the wrong decision, because we do want him to...
Die!
So, I've got two harmonicas, which are in key of B and A, so there's a choice.
Don't worry, that's
what
I'm going to
sing to today.
Great.
At any appropriate moment. And we're just going to open it practically on a random page. Does anyone want to roll your dice and be a record keeper for this in any way? Right, you're in. Come on down. I'm also going to cheat with the numbers as well. So if you want to sit down there, you're not allowed to sit down.
There you go.
And
someone's doing their exams.
It's been a long day.
Ian, it's your convention.
No, it's not. Right.
No, okay, I just like the idea.
It says on the program I'm a special guest.
Yeah, great. How good was the convention?
Well, the special guest said it's been a long day.
Right, the way this is going to go, we're going to start on this random page, really, and because it is late, I'm going to have to wear my glasses, and I can hardly see anything anymore. So, Mr. John Robertson.
Hello.
Time to die.
Oh! You've seen my
You've been wandering down this Deathtrap Dungeon. For anyone who doesn't know, you're competing with all of the others. Only one person got out alive, but no one usually does. This geezer over here fancies his chances. We suspect him not. So, do you want to roll a few random numbers for him for skill?
Yeah.
And the usual stuff.
Oh, get fucked! I did two!
And he rolls
over. No, let him do it! Better!
24 stamina.
24 stamina, yes!
Oh, wait, it's one.
Is there an overhead camera?
8 for skill, 24
for... So you crack with the sword,
yep.
You can soak a bit of damage up, and you're pretty lucky.
Right.
Is that like the summer of your life?
Yeah, pretty close.
I really like having a high rating for stamina, that's nice. No blue pill for Johnny. That's a Viagra joke, mate.
Let's get on with this thing. So there is a large panel of glass in the left-hand wall of the tunnel. Through you can see a bright, torch-lit room teeming with giant insects of every possible description. Bees, wasps, beetles, ticks, even the mites are over 6 centimetres long.
What a thrill!
The noise is threatening. In the middle of the room, a jewel crown lies on top of a small table. What looks like a large diamond is set in the middle of the crown. Will you break the glass and try to snatch the crown, continue west, or return to the junction to head north? By the way, he's already in the dungeon, in case you hadn't gathered. Okay, miserable warrior, what wilt thou choose?
Well, those insects look threatening, many of them quite large in the metric system. in fact, I'm apparently such an expert on insects that I'm just looking on, my God, that mite is 6 centimetres long. No, I don't think that I'll be braving it for a mere diamond. I shall proceed west.
Now go north.
No. Oh, am I wrong? Should I?
Some advice from you guys. Don't just smile passively.
Break the glass!
This is
For people who want me to die, you like the word diamond and you're emphasizing it a lot, right? Diamond! So, fine. Let us smash the glass, doing battle with these insects of moderately threatening size.
There's bigger ones than us.
Okay. You smash the glass with the hilt of your sword, making a hole big enough to climb through. Immediately the giant...
That is the sword! No, the mites are 6 centimetres long. I just smashed a hole big enough to get through with my bloody hilt. That's amazing.
Okay. Shut up.
Okay.
All the time, you clamber in the room, grabbing one of the lit torches to defend yourself. The fire keeps most of the insects at bay. So by the time you snatch the crown and climb back into the corridor, some will certainly have stung you.
Oh no!
Roll one dice and add 2 to the total. This is the number of giant stings you have received. Lose 1 stamina for each one.
Oh, I've lost 7 stamina. Bring me
8.
Oh,
yeah. Much of provisions get 4 stamina.
Okay. Thanks, mate. That was helpful.
You examine the crowd.
Ah!
And see with disgust that is merely painted iron.
Right.
And the diamond is just glass, totally worthless.
These people are the insects.
John, you should go away, Slime.
Yeah, I know. All I hear you talk is
bzzz. Yeah, the diamonds.
You throw it to the ground in rage.
Oh, I'm so angry.
And wonder where to go next.
Oh, God.
Will you go west or will you go north?
Oh, yeah. Keeper and advisor.
You've never played this game.
Also, I will point out. I don't recall at which point you were made advisor or bookkeeper. You're a gin with a pad and some dice. Shut up. Or more to the point, be the plot of several Stephen King novels. Now, right, I choose. I'm gonna. Oh yeah, I'll do it because we do it in my game. I will go north.
North it is.
Okay. Great.
Who knows what number it goes to?
Sure,
14, in case you're wondering. The tunnel leads into a dark chamber covered in thick cobwebs. Clawing your way through them, you trip over a wooden casket.
Wait a minute. If the insects were over 6 centimetres long, and now there are cobwebs, how big are the spiders? About the same size as getting on.
If you wish,
it was very funny when he made it about 10 minutes ago.
Right. Yes, count. You've done?
Yes. Right. Yes.
Well, thanks for coming, though.
Yeah. It was for charity. You get what you pay for.
If you wish to try to open the casket, will you do that, or will you carry on north?
Alright, what are you doing? Casket.
He doesn't know it. He's a bookkeeper.
Man, stop. Oh, he doesn't know anything. He's a bookkeeper. He bloody knows your tax secrets, Livingstone. Someone's got something in the Cayman Islands. Now, that may not be true, but prove it. Now! What do you reckon? Open the casket? Yeah, might as well. Yeah. Every time I see a casket, I think, oh yeah, give it a go. We open the casket!
Yeah. Are you going to try and open the
casket? Oh, crap! Oh, right.
God, I've forgotten how good this is. The casket opens easily.
Oh! Yay!
And inside, there's a black velvet bag containing a large pearl.
Oh! Yes.
Add one luck point. Yeah. So, you press on through the cobwebs.
This is
you
like
reach the far wall of the chamber and see two doors. Will you open the door on your left or the door on your right?
Oh.
Remembering your treachery. I shall open the door to the left.
As you turn the door handle, it goes soft in your hand.
You're probably familiar with that.
When you try to pull your hand away, you find it's glued to the handle.
Now that I am familiar with
you. A giant fist forms in the centre of the door panel and shoots forward, punching you in the stomach.
Oh!
Is that your stomach? Yes, you in the stomach.
Mate, I'm not a good actor. I've got a single punching setting. I'm like a PS1 graphic.
Lose one stamina point.
Oh, me stamina.
Completely unfair because you've got no chance to have this already, but we'll let the audience decide whether you have it or not.
Oh.
Does he have a jug of acid?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. No, but he took a tab of it before the show.
Is it yes or no?
Yes.
I think you might be on his side.
Thanks, mate. Alright.
Okay, with your free hand, you reach into your backpack and take out the jug, and corking it with your teeth.
Oh, that seems loud.
You pour acid over the door, which is in fact the fluid form of an imitator. A jet of smoke rises from it and a loud hissing sound as the acid immediately starts to burn the imitator. It melts rapidly, and you're able to step away unharmed, having no other choice. You somewhat apprehensively turn the handle of the other door.
I'm somewhat apprehensive. Yeah.
The door opens into a tunnel running north. Ahead you see two stone fountains, one on either side of the tunnel, carved in the shape of cherubs. Water spouts from their mouths and cascades into small bowls at their feet. Will you drink from the fountain on the left? Drink from the fountain on your right, or continue to walk north.
Drink.
Now, let's be fair and let's be clear. The acid is gone. I'm not going to lean over and go, oh, whoops. Okie dokie.
No, that was earlier near the beginning.
Hey,
quiet, future me. Now. Nice to see you again, for the first time. Now, tell you what, right, I'm hearing a lot of talk about this left fountain, I'm hearing a lot of good things about the left fountain. I do suspect, however, after the left door was an imitator, perhaps that is another one, but let's have ourselves a little sup from the left fountain.
Okie dokie.
is that written on all the pages, isn't it?
Okie dokie.
The cool water is refreshing, but comes from a source which has been cursed by a hag.
Ah, oh, damn it.
Add one stamina point to the water, but lose two luck points.
No. I feel better, but unlucky.
Add a drink from the other fountain, or walk north.
Oh.
Drink. Buoyed up by my excess of stamina and my lack of luck. Of course, why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I just go drink more water arbitrarily? Yes, let's do it.
Okay.
Ah!
The cool water is refreshing you.
Oh, good.
Source, which has been sprinkled with pixie dust.
Ah!
Yay. Add one stamina point and add two skill points.
Yay. Wow.
Properly refreshed, you head north.
Ah, excellent.
And on the left-hand wall of the tunnel, you see a pair of bamboo stilts. They are securely chained, and you see a label attached to a padlock which reads, "The price of these stilts is one gold piece. Place the gold coin in the slot to release the lock. Will you buy the stilts, or would you rather just keep walking north?" You look a little, shall we say, vertically challenged.
Thank you, Ian.
Thanks, mate. Now, a little bit of body positivity goes a long way. Thanks, pal. That's right. Thank you, Ian. I'm well.
It's only from my,
No, make no mistake. You speak from experience. So, you know what? Just for the purpose of the fact that if I buy the stilts and I use them, I'll have an excuse to stand on that table for some time. Right. Using this gold that I was storing near the acid I apparently had. Let's buy some stilts.
In a dungeon.
Yeah. Well, why not? There are lots of things in dungeons.
They're cheap, aren't they?
They are cheap.
There is a slot in the padlock into which you place the coin. Immediately the lock clicks apart and you're able to unchain the stilts. You place them on your shoulder and set up north.
Why would I put them on my shoulder?
Because it's a very low ceiling.
Because it's a low ceiling. Then why did I buy the fucking stilts in the first place? No, seriously, I'm just walking along. I'll tell you what this means. More bloody heist. Net that's 12 centimeters long. I'll get some stilts, it'll think I'm one of them.
A little further on, you come to a section of the tunnel which is covered with thick green slime. It looks threatening, so you decide to test it.
Oh, mate, that's what I do in bars.
Yes. Slime's corrosive jelly burns the pop instantly, leaving no trace. If you're carrying a pair of stilts. You climb onto the stilts and take a few tentative steps across the floor. Your confidence grows and soon you feel able to tackle the walk across the slime. Smoke rises from the base of the stilts and the slime starts to burn them away. You plod solidly on and finally reach firm ground again. Unfortunately, the stilts are still covered in slime and you're forced to dump them. Setting off again. You come to a junction. Will you go west or continue north?
Go west!
Yes!
Go north!
Yes!
You know what? Yes, let us, as the village people did, go west. Going west.
Okay.
Thank you.
You walk no more than 3 meters west before you hit an invisible barrier.
Oh, Christ.
It starts fizzing and crackling and you are thrown back. Oof. Hit an energy screen. Lose one stamina point.
Oh no! Me stamina!
You have no alternative but to go north.
Go north!
Oh, really? Oh, I think I will! I'm going to go north! Let's go north!
Good choice. You soon arrive at a double door in the left-hand wall. You listen at the door but hear nothing.
Ooh.
Try the handle, it turns, you open the door left slightly and peer through the crack. An armed warrior is lying face down on the floor of a bare room with smooth walls and a low ceiling. He looks like he is dead, for he makes no movement even when you call out to him.
Hey,
are you back?
He did? He's dead.
A large jewel that looks a bit like a diamond, but it just...
Oh, does it?
Beyond his
that how you escape out of
beyond his outstretched arm.
Right.
this diamond. Or
and your diamond.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Do you want to enter the room and take the jewel that is just beyond his reach?
Oh, goodness.
And he's dead.
Right.
Or would you carry on north?
Well.
Oh, do I need the diamond? Do I need? Because it couldn't possibly just be glass with painted iron.
It doesn't have.
Shall I get the diamonds?
Yes.
North.
Well, you were right about the stilts. Let's go get the diamond.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point. Do I have a pointy stick? I used to have some stilts, and those
now
are
we again, sticks. You're going to rely on the audience to...
for everything.
...determine your fate.
Oh, okay.
Because if you have drunk the potion, find inside a black leather book. That's one option. But if you've not drunk it, it's another option. So has he drunk, or would you like to say you've drunk it or not?
Oh, sure. Yeah, no, I've got it.
Mate, I was drunk before I got here.
where did he find this potion, by the way? Anyone know?
You were signing them outside. It was amazing.
The
black leather book. It was a limited run of 400 copies.
We still got a few left.
Oh, do you? Golly! Well, the charity can get stuff done,
mate. So you have drunk this potion.
Have
you got an adventurer? Are we happy with that audience?
Yeah!
There's always one.
We're about to enter the room when the potion of trap detection begins to work.
It's a trap!
And you're filled
it's a trap.
With a terrible premonition of danger.
Uh-oh.
The room is set with a deadly trap. You decide not to go in and carry on north. They saved you.
Thanks, guys.
I'm not gonna. We love you, Darren.
Can I just explain the rules one more time? This is not the outcome we're looking for.
I will also point out, without having a spell of trap detection, I never would have figured out that the dead man on the floor, who hadn't yet reached the treasure, had in any way been subject to a trap. It's so lucky I had the potion of spotting the fucking obvious.
Yes, there's a lot of double bluffs in this.
I'm aware! I remember the last time
the tunnel continued north of quite a distance before coming to a dead end.
Oh no!
The mouth of a chute shoots from the west wall, and it appears the only alternative to turning back.
The mouth of a what?
Chute.
Of a chute. Oh,
shoot.
Shoot.
Shoot. That's with a C-H-U-T-E.
Oh, okay.
Sort of what? You might shoot down the chute.
I'm all right. Okay, I will then.
Okay. You slide down and emerge in a room, landing on your back.
My worker's comp.
As soon as you stand up, you're confronted by the most repulsive sight you've ever laid your eyes on.
The most what?
Repulsive.
Oh, repulsive, I heard impulsive. No, I'm so excited by it.
In your dreams.
Yes.
There in front of you, wallowing in a circular pool of fetid slime, is a bald creature. And covered all over with fearsome looking spikes, his face is a mass of crimson blisters.
Oh, he's got spikes, hasn't he?
One of which suddenly first revealed yet another of its many sinister, all seeing eyes. A narrow path runs around the edge of the pool, leading to another tunnel in the far wall. It is the loathsome blood beast. Which you've read about in that leather-bound book.
Oh, I remember.
You do remember.
I do remember. There I was drinking, reading about a loathsome
blood beast. Do you remember what happened with this book that you didn't read, but say you have?
Well, I drank the potion, so no.
Have you read this book or not?
No. Hang on. Who says yes? Thanks.
Looks like you haven't.
Oh, no!
I wonder what might happen.
There's no way a book aimed at children could possibly punish someone for not reading.
The blood beast flops around in its pool, and the smell of the poisonous fumes makes you retch.
Oh, don't worry, mate.
The gas bubbles break the surface and contaminate the atmosphere. Will you run around the side of the pool towards the tunnel opposite? Throw a gem into the pool, if you have one. Have you? Or attack it with your sword.
Oh, wait a minute, I don't have a sword. No, I do. I'm just glad with you. I remember.
This is by the fancy book. It says you start with a sword.
Oh, cool.
I'm shit with it, but you do get one.
Yes. I'm shit with it, but I've got one. Thanks. Oh, that's good. Oh, I can't wait for my participation award.
And the sword is shit.
And the sword is shit. Fucking great. How shit is it? It's not even a sword. It's just a bloody plant, mate.
Are you going to run around?
Oh, well, hands
run around the pool.
How's my stamina?
Throw a gem into the pool.
Right.
That gem you haven't got. Yep. Or attack it with your sword.
I'm going to... Well, let's see.
We will fight this fearsome beast with our shit sword.
Here's the hilt.
Yes! Oh, yeah, I mean, the hilt opened a bloody hole I could fit through. Imagine what I could do to that.
How do you sense spells you come? As you make a lunge at the blood beast, you suddenly start to feel faint.
Oh no.
The gas rising up from the pool is highly toxic.
As I told you,
I didn't explain a minute ago. You slump to the floor unconscious.
Oh, no.
Test your luck. And I think we should let him throw his own dice.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Our bookkeeper here will say whether you're lucky or unlucky.
Okie dokie. Two dice, this is?
Double six.
Oh no, no one can see that one! What a shame!
But that one's a six.
So! Two!
Still lucky.
Yeah. Bastard.
I almost screwed myself.
Yeah, you go low.
You're not if you're lower.
Oh, I see.
You're cheating, you have lost.
Oh, no. Well, what a lesson learned.
Same or less than is good.
Okay, well.
That's why you want a high score for your initial roll.
I see.
Oh, I've learned a thing or two about morality today.
The blood beast is too bulbous to climb out of his pool, but its long tongue whips out and tries to wrap itself around your leg. Fortunately, you're beyond its reach.
I am.
The air at ground level does not contain any poisonous fumes, but you wake with a pain in your throat. You cover your mouth with your sleeve so that you can breathe through it and decide what to do. Will you run around the pool to the tunnel opposite? Or will you attack the blood beast with your sword?
Oh, bring forth again the shit sword!
Can I just remind you what you're up against?
That's illustration!
Okay, you land at the blood beast, trying to avoid the tongue which flicks out to grab your leg. Roll two dice. Let me help you out here, I'll tell you what to do. If the total is the same or less than your skill, one thing happens. If it's greater, another thing happens.
Okie dokie.
What is your skill?
It's 10, it's greater. It's greater than skill.
Greater than?
Yes.
Oh, I don't know that. Your reactions are still slow because of the poison in your system, and although you tried to jump over the Asterix tongue, your leg let you down.
Oh no, my leg.
The sticky tongue wraps itself around your leg, flipping you over and starts to pull you towards the pool. Your sword is slipped out of your hand and you start to panic.
Oh, I'm panicking.
Do you have a dagger?
What?
Do you have a dagger?
Yes! Yes!
I will have you know that anytime my sword stops being interested, it becomes a dagger. Yes.
If that joke was good enough and Shakespeare, it's good enough for me. Now, I say I have a dagger. Have I a dagger, friends?
Yes!
Dagger!
I have a dagger.
Oh,
I have
a dagger. Doesn't have
a... Oh, happy dagger!
I've got a dagger.
Mate, Ian, this is London. Most of us have knives, right?
It's amazing how many towns that joke works in.
Yeah.
Okay, you had a dagger.
I do have a dagger.
It's really sympathy, mate. You pull the dagger from your belt with your free hand and hack at the blood beast's tongue. The beast screams in pain and rolls forward as far as it can to try and clasp you between its blood-filled jaws. You must fight it from the floor with your dagger. Reduce your skill by 2 during this combat because you have not got your sword. Okay, the blood beast has a skill of 12 and a stamina of 10. But if you win an attack round, you may test your luck and possibly run away. But probably not. But let's give it a shot, shall we? Okay, you're lucky.
Thank you. Thank you, friend. All right. Hi.
Remember cheating.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I will roll now.
The fearsome blood beast.
happy dagger.
Spend a lot of blood. You're at
16.
You got 16.
Yes.
It gets 18.
I was happy about nothing.
Right. Oh! Yes. Yes!
No!
Okay, so the beast rolled 2, which makes it 14. He gets 3, which makes it 9. He gets hit again, and he's down to 13 stamina.
Keep going, we can get him.
Alright. Okay. It's... we got 2 and 3!
Damn it!
Roll higher!
I'm trying! Come on!
You suck! Still losing! Right! Oh, what a shame! Okay, let's go! 3! No!
Amazing, I got one. I landed. Good times.
That was 3 and 1, so that's 4, so 16 plus 7, 13. Still get hit.
No more dice for you, young friend.
I've lost my place in the book.
Oh, what a shame! Oh no, did you think we'd gone down a narrative cul-de-sac and decided to save us suddenly?
I thought you were just gonna die.
Yeah. Thanks, mate. Alright.
Does anyone remember what number that was?
It worked. There you go.
Oh, I'm back to you. Have you won a attack round? You can test your luck.
Oh, yes, not a attack round.
Oh, sorry.
What? Where are these cameras? They move? What? Well, they don't move very far, do they?
It's electrovator.
Yes. I'm not going to lie. I was at uni 20 years ago. We didn't have these.
Right.
18.
Can I roll higher than 18?
No.
From a base of 5? No, I can't. For sure. No. As it turned out, no.
Wow. Look at you just quietly enjoying yourself.
Just bleed faster, would you?
Give me some aspirin.
Nice.
Test your luck and be unlucky when you get hit.
Actually, yeah. I already wrote down 0.
Sure. Let's test our luck.
Roll 2 dice.
Rolling 2 dice.
Rolling to die.
Yes. Very good, friend. Very good. That's what we need at this late hour, wordplay.
There's nothing else left.
No, so you didn't do one. Just a sentence.
Right.
Lucky.
Yes! Yes! I run. I run.
You've tested your luck.
I have.
Lucky. Let's see what awaits you.
Oh, goody. It's called Deathtrap Dungeon. This will end well.
Unknown to you, the Blood Beast has only one weakness, its real eyes. More by chance than by design, you plunge your blade deep into one of them.
Ha!
And the Blood Beast immediately slumps back into its pool. After a few massive convulsions, it sinks beneath the oily surface of the pool. Not waiting to see whether it recovers, you run into a tunnel, anxious to get away from the Blood Beast's toxic chamber. I'm really upset you defeated me. However, you're frighteningly weak in the moment, which is good.
Eat all your provisions, you'll get
through. Sorry, what a wonderful insult is. You're frighteningly weak.
The tunnel leads into a large room. Its ceiling supported by several marble pillars. As you enter the room, you suddenly see a strange beast to your right. It is the body of a lion with dragon-like wings attached to it, but its head is like that of an old bearded man. If you have read the poem written on the skeleton warrior's parchment, or you have not read it, have you read this poem?
Grimy. Unfortunately, my eyesight was too falteringly poor to read the poem. I'm committing to the idea.
You are frighteningly weak to be able to do so.
Yes, I'm committed to the idea that I'm frail.
So, has he not read this poem?
No! I've never read any poem. Rhyming is too hard.
The beast before you is a manticore. The tip of its tail sprouts profusion of sharp spikes. Hard as iron bolts. So it inflicts his tail, sending a body of iron spikes towards you. Roll one die. This is the number of spikes that hit your body.
Six.
Three.
And you lose 2 standard points for each.
Oh, I see.
You're a bit frighteningly weak, as we just described.
Yeah.
And frighteningly dead.
So, what is he?
He's alive! He's alive!
He's alive! He's alive!
Thank you, folks.
Unlucky. Unlucky. If only I had taken the steroids on page 3 earlier.
Oh, use your stilts.
Yeah. What? Oh.
In a more beneficial way. So I think, ladies and gentlemen, that's about it. Where, I don't know where John Green is. John, where are you? We've got to conclude this event.
Use your stilts, mate.
Harmonica.
Yes.
Shall we?
Yes.
Oh, just for old time's sake.
Yes, come for it.
You're going to dance. You're going to dance.
Yeah, I shall dance and maybe sing.
Oh! Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Does it come through the mic?
Yeah. I'll tell you a story about a young man sitting down doing maths and rolling dice like a motherfucker. Thank you.
brings a joy to us all, where every word that comes out with frighteningly weak mouth. Mr. John Robertson.
In a small recess on the left-hand wall, you see a section of bamboo standing on its end. Lifting it down, you see it is filled with a clear liquid. Your throat is painfully dry, and you feel a little dizzy from the heat in the tunnel.